I'm Dr. Beth Ross, and I'm a veterinarian here at Pine Bush Equine. So we have 10 veterinarians here on staff, and they range anywhere from having experience of 30 years and with advanced training to some of our youngest members that have been here, the full veterinarians, but have been here for a year. The surgery procedure goes, most of these horses, a lot of them are diagnosed within our own practice, but some of them come from outside veterinarians as well. Those horses will have been looked at by a veterinarian and had x-rays taken and a diagnosis made. The horses, typically they will arrive the evening before and settle in a little bit. They'll have a physical examination performed. They'll be cleaned up. Then the horses are brought to an induction area. They're given a little bit of what we call pre-medication, where it makes them a little bit relaxed. We give them the induction agent, which allows their muscles to completely relax, and we support them as they recline and then lay on the ground, and then they're intubated. And the hobbles are placed on their legs to bring them over to the table using a hoist system. Surgery, the horses are positioned properly. They are hooked up to the anesthesia equipment and the monitoring equipment. The surgical site is prepared, surgery is performed, and then they're placed into the recovery stall.
All right, well, I'm Dr. Michael Ross, and I'm owner of Pine Bush Equine Services and Veterinary Hospital. And I primarily do in-hospital veterinary medicine, meaning surgery and lameness examinations, bone scans, and things of that nature. What we did is a right hock and left hind fetlock arthroscopy. And arthroscopy is a minimally invasive surgical procedure that we brought to Pine Bush Equine back in 1988, basically. It was one of the first things that I ended up doing, one of the first surgical procedures I ended up doing up here. It wasn't the very first, but almost one of the first. And basically what we were doing is using the arthroscope to evaluate the interior of those joints and removing OCD, or osteochondritis dissecans fragments. OCD is a hereditary condition in some horses that causes pieces of bone and cartilage to detach or not actually form normally. Those fragments can drop off, for instance, they can float around and be loose fragments or wobble in the joint and cause inflammation. And so we oftentimes, like in this horse, take them out before the horse goes to the sale or goes into training as a potential racehorse. Yeah, I was always interested in horses. My sister and I grew up having horses ourselves, and so my sister actually went to Cornell, and so I followed her to Cornell undergraduate, and then soon became interested in the equine research program at Cornell. I became interested in going into veterinary school, and of course it made sense that with my equine background I would go into equine veterinary medicine. As far as surgery goes, I guess I was introduced to surgery through some of my mentors. Surgery is basically anatomy, and I had a true interest in anatomy, and so it made sense that I went into something that I could use anatomy every day. That's what I do. I pretty much practice in the equine anatomical arena doing surgery.